Hello there, Insomaniacs, and welcome back for more Pokemon Diamond Nuzlocke with Konis board. Today, we're going to carry on with the rest of Route 210 after that horrible mistake I made, aka Handy cannot use the fog. So now we're going to actually head on to the foggy area this time around. Oh, of course, there's cut, meaning I need Handy. Yeah, no thanks game, let's use the fog. Okay, I'm going to say, don't bother, just bring a HM slave which knows the fog, because I'm going to say right now, if you let the fog stay, seriously, it'll be annoying as heck. Look at, even this guy says so. If I can use the hidden move, the fog, I'll clear up the weather. The fog, but Pokemon flap their wings to blow the fog away. So that's why only flying type mons can use the fog. Oh, I just started you while you were struggling to recover. I'll already be the winner. Ninja boys don't have good disguises. I thought it was some kind of hidden item, but no, of course it was a ninja boy. With a Zubat, you're not worth my time. Oh, but Ryoko's in front. Oh, that might suck. Okay, let's switch out the Grodus, because Zubat is part poison type, meaning that Grodus actually has a super effective move against it, so the battle is pretty much already won. Whoa, freaking confused Ray. I was like, oh, the battle is pretty much already won because I have a super effective move. Then I forget. Zubat are well known for confused Ray. Is this a Petra? No, this is a Petra. Where are my Persims? 123. Back when I first played Pokemon Leaf Green when I was a kid, I didn't have Persim Berries, or I didn't know that the flute woke you. Long story short, confusion sucks. Yeah, basically, I had in Leaf Green, you pretty much have to switch out a Pokemon to avoid getting confused, and really, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. Not worth my effort. One hit KO. And I thought Grodus' offenses kinda suck. Oh well, I guess I was wrong. Good thing Grodus, you pleasantly surprised me. Okay, another Zubat. Oh, this guy gonna have all Zubats? Then I'm gonna just mash the A button and wreck him with extra sensory. Freaking confused Ray. I see this guy's strategy now. He wants to confuse me to the end of time. See, hurt myself in confusion. Okay, let's use another Persim Berry because this sucks. Confusion sucks. It's pretty much a luck-based move. It's like 50-50. You have a 50% chance of hitting your opponent and you have a 50% chance of hitting yourself. It's just a pain. Okay, wow, really? This is starting to annoy me a lot. I believe Grodus has a mind plate, meaning that his psychic type moves do more damage, which is good because Grodus is steel psychic type, and since steel types weren't nerfed in this game, unlike Gen 6, it's OP as oh, go bad. This changes everything. Goodbye, Grodus. I think White Lion should handle this one. I'm legitimately surprised you have a Golbat. I thought it would be a Zubat for sure. Okay, not bad. I think this is the first time we've seen a Golbat. I may be wrong though, but a Golbat is the evolved form of Zubat. It has a pretty cool design, but its evolution Crobat has the best design. It's one of the best poison type mons you can find out there, so yeah. It's still horrendously weak though, to poison, ice, psychic, all those sort of weaknesses. You get the message, you get my drift. Skorupi, another Skorupi. Alright, come out Lombax, it's a poison bug type, so you should use a fire type move on it. Again, as I said, Diamond and Pearl kind of lacks in fire type. It's either Ponyta or Chimchar, and I didn't pick Chimchar. So yeah, I'm stuck with Ponyta. At least in Platinum, they give you a lot more other stuff, like I think they give you Magma, they give you Houndour. Knock off! Oh, doy. That was my Citrus Berry. Knock off! It's really only useful in competitive. It pretty much knocks off the item you're holding. I'm not sure if your item will return to you at the end of the battle. I may have to go check that out. Okay. Bye-bye, Ninja Boy. Oh, what's that? You're supposed to be fumbling more. Yeah, I'm supposed to be fumbling more, huh? I need a better reaction out of you. I feel silly hiding for so long. Good, Lombax's berry is back. Okay, now what? Oh boy, is that an ace trainer? It better not be an ace trainer. It's an ace trainer, isn't it? It has to be an ace trainer. Well, this sucks. This really, really sucks. Okay, who should I send out? You know what? Lombax. I have... Lombax is on a roll lately, so I'm gonna try to keep Lombax out. As an ace trainer, I have to take battles and try. I need to stay cool and calm, whether I win or lose. Look at those ace trainers talking so professionally. And the thing is, they have the right to brag. Ace trainers in this generation are real trolls. You have a Ponyta. And it's level 27 too. I regret leaving to you in the PC. Okay, Ponytas are hard hitters, so I think... I'm just going to go with the one with it has the most base stat, aka White Lion. Because Ponytas are really hard hitters, they're really fast too. That's basically their main gimmick. Their offensive hitter really growl. For an ace trainer, I expected better AI. Yeah, that's the thing, they have different AI levels. For example, ace trainers AI, typically their Pokemon will use smarter moves. Ace trainers and gym leaders and all that stuff. Okay, good. Almost down. And there is... Really? Growl? And the game suddenly wants to contradict me. It's like I say ace trainers have horrendously good AI, and then this Ponyta is spamming growl. Then again, I think she could be trying to set up for next mon. I don't know. I can't, like, you know, jump to conclusions, but still. Growl. Nah, she just sucks. Okay, Damien, your call. Good thing that Damien is ridiculously fast and that Grotto is ridiculously slow, meaning that she's kinda screwed. Really? The ace trainer from before was a lot harder. I believe, hey, is Rick's Grotto actually higher level than yours? If that's the case, then that is sad. Okay, bye bye. It shouldn't be able to survive that. It really shouldn't. Oh, it did. Okay, whatever. Okay, bite. You know what? That wasn't actually... too bad. Okay, let's use Wing Attack, finish it off. Wing Attack has a much more epic animation in Gen 3. Gen 3, you flap like two miniature tornadoes and fling it at your opponents. It looks so ridiculously epic in that game. Okay, there we go. Shell Bell. I actually forgot I had it. I haven't used Damien in ages. We lost. Yep, you lost. How dare you beat us? Go away, go! Two ace trainers. Looks like it's gonna be a double battle too. Well. This does not look good. Okay, not the Pokedex. What should I do? I think I'm gonna just put my two strongest mon in front, because this does not look good. Jen, what's this? I'm gonna use everything you taught me. Here comes the trainer. Zach, you ready? Let's do this! Double battles. Yeah, this sucks. Double team Zach and Jen. Send out Gyarados and Rao, boy. Oh boy, I know this. I heard horror stories of this battle. Basically, how this battle works is that, Gyarados will set up Rain Dance and Raichu will spam Thunder, I think. And the worst part of all is that Defog is... If you didn't use Defog, the fog will be active, meaning you can't hit them that well. So you know what I must say to that? Forget that, I'm just gonna kill them straight away. No mercy. Tail Whip, really? Don't tell me I got prepared just for you to use Tail Freaking Whip. There. Hopefully it'll take out the Gyarados in one shot, because I really don't want to deal with that thing. It's freaking annoying. Man, Tajiu is gonna be so underleveled. By the time I hit Celestic Town, I'm gonna have to grind him. Okay, that's good. And Ryoko used Magical Leaf. I'm not sure if it will KO the Raichu. Probably not, but at least we got some things done. It did? Oh, it was a crit. Well, so much for being overly prepared for this battle. It's just that I heard horror nightmare stories about this one. But then I breezed through it. Wow, someone that's even better than Jen. I just got embarrassed in front of my little buddy here. Zach, I'm so sorry. I'm a failure as your instructor. I don't care if I get to meet the greatest trainer in the region. I'll still rather learn from Jen. Oh, that's sad. Another ace trainer? You can't be serious. Why the sudden ace trainer spam? Really? You seem to have a lot of confidence. Let's see if it's justified. Yeah, my confidence just got lost the moment an ace trainer showed up. Yeah, there's a lot of horror stories about ace trainer, really. More damn, this is a bug-type Pokemon, meaning Lombax should wreck him. Bug flying, it's one of the evolved forms of Brumi. Okay, let's use Ember. It shouldn't survive. I forget Lombax is still kind of low level. Ew, Silver Wind. That's actually quite a powerful bug-type attack. It's an ace trainer, what do you expect? Of course, they gotta have some power. Ace trainers are kind of tough, like they're a bit of challenges, and you should be really wary of them in a Nuzlocke because, yeah. Okay, let's see. Onix. That's not half bad, really. Okay, go, Ryoko. Alright, what do we have? This thing really shouldn't be able to live after one magical leaf. I sincerely doubt that. Okay, there we go. You know what, I think I'm a bit over-prepared for the ace trainers, considering they're not really putting up as big of a fight as I thought. Then again, this isn't Platinum. In Platinum, ace trainers are horrendous dicks. I'm sorry, they really are complete jerks in that game. Okay, next up we have Luxio. Evolved form of Shinx, the electric type. I may want to take this thing down quite quickly because, wow, it's quite high level too. Because, how I say this, Luxio has a pretty high attack power, so I really don't want this thing to land a move on it. Okay, yeah, bite. Okay, that shouldn't be that bad. Okay, let's Mega Drain that damage back. That's why I still keep Mega Drain. It's actually still handy for stuff like this. Like, you will wonder why would I keep a dumb move like Mega Drain? Well, look at that. This is why I keep Mega Drain. It's quite useful, honestly. Ryoko grew to level 31. There we go. Ryoko wants to learn the move Sweet Scent. Heck no. No way. I am not learning Sweet Scent. No way. Total loss for me. Yeah, your Dawnrat is a total loss for you. You seem to have an abundance of talent, it's pretty amazing. Really? How long does this road go? What's down here? Oh, you can't be serious, this is... Oh, of course! Rock Smash. I didn't notice that guy there. A ninja can use all sorts of cool techniques! Alright, last trainer battle of the episode. It's kind of going out of hand already. Ninja Boy DeVito, send out Dustox. What's with the sudden spam of Bug-type Pokemon? You're just making Lombax's job easy. Anyway, Dustox is one of the evolved form of Wurmple. Protag, I saw that coming. Later on in the game, you'll be seeing Team Galactic spam these mons. A lot. At least in Diamond, what? But it failed. Okay, good. That actually didn't do as much damage as I thought. I guess maybe because it's level 27? Wow, that's the same level as Grodus. I better do some more grinding. Oh, that may hurt. Okay, you are getting annoying. There we go. Nice. Super effective. Oh, Dustox fainted. Nice! Lombax grew to level 30. Finally, I used Lombax. My ninja techniques failed to work. Yeah, darn right they failed to work. If you enjoyed this episode of Pokemon Diamond Nuzlocke with Konis bot, do feel free to leave a like or be an anti-boredom fighter and check out my channel. Do feel free to keep up with the Insomania by subscribing to Insomania Game. And next time, we are going to take on the rest of Route 210 and head towards Celestic Town to deliver the old charm to Cynthia's grandmother. See you guys then.